WQE 99.1 FM, The Key, Newnan, Sharpsburg, Franklin, LaGrange.
The House of Light brings clarity to your soul, offering a safe space for healing through our compassionate practitioners, services, classes, and wisdom, plus the tools to support you in our retail space.
To protect his home and family from disaster, Steve used courage, wisdom, and his camera phone.
That should do it.
Way to go, Steve! By simply taking digital pictures of his family's important documents, Steve can always have them stored safely online, no matter when disaster strikes. Learn other simple ways to protect your home and family before a natural disaster at ready.gov. That's ready.gov. A message from FEMA and the Ad Council.
Hey, Coach Prime. I think you've got what it takes to wear the Aflac at
style, charisma, and a smile that's 21 out of 10.
Aflac. You know Aflac can help keep unexpected health care costs from ruining someone's finances. Check out this coverage.
Still got it, Coach. You still got it.
Aflac.
Never lost it.
Yeah.
Aflac.
You see that coverage? With that wingspan, I see why you got more rings than a cell phone.
There's always room for one more.
Yeah.
Get help with expenses health insurance doesn't cover at Aflac.com.
The views and opinions of this show and program are not the views and opinions of this station, its management, or its clientele.
Good morning. Welcome to WQEE 99.1. I'm Donna.
And I am Bruce.
And this is Lyrical Wisdom. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, each and every one of you, and good morning, Bruce.
Good morning, Donna.
How are you doing today?
I'm doing wonderfully, and we are looking at a camera, and we are also talking to each other, and this is very exciting. Good morning to everybody out there listening. Welcome to Lyrical Wisdom. We love the fact that we have anybody listening to us, and we look forward to talking today. What a beautiful day.
Yes, it is.
Oh, my goodness.
I love this fall weather.
Yes.
Absolutely love it. It kind of like it cools things down.
Yeah.
Slows things down. And the only thing that isn't going slow, however, seems to be time. Right?
Time is moving, yeah.
I mean, Bruce, I was just here with you yesterday.
That is true.
Doesn't it feel like just yesterday?
It does. It just feels like...
It's incredible how quickly the time is going.
It is incredible.
Yeah.
And I guess, you know, it seems like it's moving so quickly, but I also feel like that old... Well, I don't know if it's old or new, but the saying that it's all happening at the same time, that certainly feels like it's all happening at the same time. That is for sure.
Exactly.
So.
And time is doing such weird things.
It is. And I guess, you know, we could kind of wonder if we could have time in a bottle.
Good lead-in, Bruce. All right. I love that. Yes, yes, yes. It is such a beautiful lead-in for today's song. We have a request today from Vanya. Vanya LeBeau from Moreland.
Yes.
Vanya is a good friend of ours sent this directly to the Lyrical Wisdom Show at gmail.com.
Yes.
lyricalwisdomshow@gmail.com. But you can also send your requests to
99classicrock@gmail.com. That's 99classicrock@gmail.com. And you can also check out our YouTube site. It is Lyrical Wisdom on YouTube. And if you search Lyrical Wisdom, you may have to scroll down a little bit, but we definitely have our channel up and functioning, and we have videos there that are like today's. We're going to be posting these and others that are going to be new updates to the show, so you can not just listen but also see us.
Right, and please check out that YouTube channel for your requests, because you know, they're coming in. Thank you guys so much. You're showing us love that way. You really, truly are. To me, it just feels fills my heart with joy when we get those requests. Yeah, it's exciting, especially to see who all's listening and where you're from.
Yeah, absolutely.
So please keep sending in those requests, and you may find your request directly on YouTube, because we are getting several requests.
We are.
And we only do one a week, so there's 52 weeks in a year, and once we get 52 requests, say, that's a whole year of requests. Well, guess what? We've already got 3/4 of a year.
Yeah, we have.
So we're starting to just put them directly on YouTube for you guys. And if you go on YouTube and click like and subscribe, guess what? You won't have to scroll anymore, because then we'll be up top.
We'll be up top, and you'll be able to find us a lot easier, because there is a little scrolling you might have to do the first time you search. But yes, Donna covered everything so well. I am just so excited about all of this, because that is a fact. We can't do the live show enough to cover every single request that we're going to get. It's going to end up being more than what we can do. So we're going to start putting them up on YouTube so that we can do extra shows and cover everybody's song.
And it's becoming a podcast.
Yes.
Yay.
Yeah, we are very excited
about
that.
Very excited. Yeah.
Yeah. So please go and check us out at Lyrical Wisdom on YouTube, and like and subscribe. And
all of this is a blessing from Ryan here at WQEE, and giving us the opportunity and being able to do this.
Absolutely.
And share a little wisdom with each and every one of you. And it's you all that are listening here today that's making this so successful, so wonderful.
Yeah, you are creating this right in front of our eyes.
Exactly.
Thank you so much. But yes, it is due to the generosity, kindness, and
honestly, your requests.
And your requests, but also the generosity and kindness of Ryan here helping us do this and giving us this format and platform and all of the good things.
Yeah.
So yes, absolutely. We definitely appreciate that. That's why you can also send requests directly to the radio station, 99classicrock@gmail.com. And that is 99classicrock@gmail.com. That's WQEE 99.1 FM. Do not be afraid to reach out for them if you don't just have a request for Lyrical Wisdom. Maybe you have something else that you've heard on this station and you want to hear something, and you want to reach out to them for that. So please reach out and feel free to express.
Yes.
And this is exciting. Vanya sent us in this request, and we're very excited about doing it.
Yeah. And I do want to say, I got a very special blessing the other day from WQEE. I got a birthday wish. That was wonderful. I had a birthday on Wednesday. All right. Time in a Bottle by Jim Croce. If I could save time in a bottle, the first thing that I'd like to do is to save every day till eternity passes away, just to spend them with you. If I could make days last forever, if words could make wishes come true, I'd save every day like a treasure, and then again, I would spend them with you. But there never seems to be enough time to do the things you want to do once you find them. I've looked around long enough to know that you're the one I want to go through time with. If I had a box just for wishes and dreams that had never come true, that box would be empty except for the memory of how they were answered by you. But there never seems to be enough time to do the things you want to do once you find them. I've looked around long enough to know that you're the one I want to go through time with. Such a beautiful, beautiful song,
beautiful,
I think.
Beautiful, yes. I was just thinking of hearing it. Whenever I hear this song, it's almost that, like, that first phrase, that first sentence, just really strikes you and sticks with you, because even the way that we led into this, that's
time.
Well, it's the title of the song, right. And it's also so iconic when you hear this, when they're singing it. It is so beautiful. If I could have time in a bottle.
If I could save time in a bottle. Right.
Yeah, wow, goodness gracious.
Yeah.
And the first thing that I'd like to do is to save every day. Wow.
Could you imagine that if you really could bottle time? I mean, that would be...
and then to save every day. Because I think one of the things that... Sometimes I feel like we hear ourselves say the phrase, you know, we're only given a day, I think is a phrase I've heard. We go, you know, we wake up in the morning and then we go to bed at night. And that is really as much as we're really given. And the time that we're spent asleep, that could be our own death and reincarnation.
Oh, it is, and Bruce.
Exactly.
It definitely is.
So,
because time, we as human beings created time so that we could move around in this physicality of Earth, of beingness here in this physical body. And time simply makes it easier for us to be somewhere, with someone, do something at a certain time.
The construct that kind of gives back to us, if you will.
Yes.
It helps us get through all of these things that we have created as needs. Some of them are just distractions, of course.
Right.
It's interesting you say that because... In a way, it's like the song becomes, thinking about that, the song kind of becomes circular. Because to think of saving time in a bottle, well, we created time. Mm-hmm. So we're creating the thing that we then want to save in a bottle.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It kind of seems a little bit circular. It seems like it's kind of, I don't know how to say it, but almost it like it's a, what's the word I'm looking for? I think it just kind of comes back on itself.
Well, for me, it seems like they're almost saying, you know, oops, maybe we shouldn't have created this time thing. Because
I think that's what a lot of people have realized now. Yeah.
Because it puts such limitations and restrictions on us.
And
it causes problems because when you tell someone you're going to be at such and such a place at such and such a time and you are 5 minutes late, then that person has gone into are they coming? You know, what's happening? And it and the person trying to get there is rushing cause an accident trying to get there in time. So, yeah, time can be very, very restrictive and very...
Suddenly it is constricting and suddenly it's stress-creating.
Stressful,
suddenly
you're
just in this area, in this space of trying to, you know, you're trying to beat time. You're trying to stay ahead of time and to be faster than time and to, you know, and that's the thing that is funny because I think a lot of us that drive a vehicle would... Sometimes maybe, I don't know, that's a double negative there, but I would kind of think that we all have the same thought when we're driving on the highway is that it seems like everybody is just trying to go faster than each other. And it's just everybody's trying to beat time. I don't think anybody's really trying to beat anybody in particular, but we are always trying to stay ahead. And so being able to capture it in a bottle till eternity passes away.
That sentence is very interesting because how can eternity pass away?
Eternity is forever. So, of course, that is the idea that time being a construct means that eternity is also a construct because that is a measure of time.
Which is infinite. Forever.
And that is interesting to think of because that is, if we, to give time a value as we have with creating it as time, then we've also created that value of either none of it or an infinite amount.
Yeah.
So that's where I kind of get that idea from. And so, but it... it would, you know, interesting to think of it that way, because then till eternity passes away, just to spend them with you. And that would be every day, every single day in that bottle, to spend them with that person, or with the you.
The capital you, too.
The capital.
Exactly. Or spend it with the essence of love, or your creator, whatever energy that you call, just that essence of love is what I believe Jim is saying in this song.
Yes.
He wants to be in that blissful moment forever.
Yeah.
And of course, he is seeing the blissful moment coming perhaps from outside of him.
Yeah.
And when you can find that bliss within, then I believe time then just kind of extends itself anyway. There is no time. I love the next paragraph in which it says, if I could make days last forever, if words could make wishes come true. I am such a advocate for the saying from Florence Shrivel, her book, Words Are Wands.
Words
are wands.
I love that. You're one
you
of the few
can make your wishes come true with words.
Yes.
And I truly believe that.
I do believe that as well. I would say as well that sometimes thinking of them as wishes or wants, we also need to give ourselves a definite answer, a definite time period where we know we can achieve and get these things and be these things. Because in some cases, having a wish is also having an indefinite time period where that could possibly happen or not.
So, that's kind of funny, because now you're back being controlled by time.
Exactly. and that's the weird, that's, it's such a funny, like a rhetorical is the word I was trying to think of earlier, and that is the way I feel, like it's almost rhetorical in its own way, because it seems to keep coming back like a boomerang on you. It keeps looping or circling back. And I'd save every day like a treasure, and then again I would spend them with you. And I love that too, just like you said, because you know, they're the one thing that a lot of people will dismiss certain activities because of not having enough time. And then they can't, this is one of the ones that I know doesn't happen a lot out there, is meditate. They can't meditate and go within and learn more, because in the next phrase to the next paragraph, but there never seems to be enough time to do the things you want to do.
Once you find them. You know, the beautiful thing, I want to go back to days just a little bit, because I now have, I say, I guess you can call them affirmations every morning. The first one I say is, I am grateful for this new day.
Beautiful.
And I think once you realize that, when you do open your eyes in the morning, it is a brand new day.
Brand new day.
Yesterday is gone. And, you know, I've heard that saying for a long time. Yesterday's gone, forget it. Tomorrow's for today.
Yeah.
You know?
Or, not the Beatles. Is it Captain and Tennille? It's a yesterday's gone. Yesterday's gone. Who sings that song? I'm sorry. I'm sorry to interrupt you, Donna, but I agree. It's interesting because, you know, we kind of forget that moment of amazing clarity of opening those eyes that first thing in that morning.
Yes, yes.
And having that affirmation.
Mm-hmm. And this whole song, like we said, is all about, I think, the essence of love.
Yes.
Never seems to be enough time to do the things you want to do once you find them.
Yeah.
I've looked around enough to know that you're the one I want to go through time with.
Ah, that is so beautiful. But that you, that capital
yes.
U, is the one we have kind of, if I may say, not vaguely, but I would say we've pretty much identified it as love, as the inside you, the person that is within. and that true inner self.
I think, yes, because I know deep down inside, I know that once you find that love, that self-love for you, capital U, Y-O-U, then you do have the capability of loving something or someone outside of you in such a beautiful way that time does slip away.
It doesn't exist.
Not it becomes anymore. Like every moment is that treasured moment that he's talking about in this song. If I could see every day like a treasure.
Yes.
Every day becomes a treasure when you find that love that I believe is in this Jim's wanting of time in a bottle.
I could agree more. And what's funny is then there's an acknowledgement within the next paragraph where he says, if I had a box just for wishes and dreams that had never come true. And when you first hear that, you're thinking, well, where is he going with this? And then, to me, he acknowledges that he has experienced this wonderful feeling and an inner place where he feels that he has already had that.
Yeah.
Because he says, the box would be empty except for the memory of how they were answered by you. And that is beautiful. Yeah, it makes it, like, bring a tear to your eye how beautiful that is. Because, you know, at first you're thinking, well, you know, if you had a box just for wishes and dreams that would never come true, it sounds like, well, this could be a little bit of a kind of nostalgic, but kind of reminiscing in a, not regretful way, but looking back with a, gosh, you know, maybe if I'd done things a little bit differently. But he doesn't say that at all.
Yeah.
He acknowledges that he has had these experiences.
Right. And all of the dreams and wishes that came true were answered by you.
Yes.
To me, very well can be someone outside of you once you have found that place within you.
Yes.
Because the wants and the needs and the desires are always fulfilled. Every morning when you open your eyes, you do become grateful for each new day.
Every single new day.
Because you know whatever is going to come that day, it's going to be a blessing.
It's going to be brand new and wonderful. And that's, you know, where there's, you know, the thing that is interesting about how he then ends with that is that I believe that he's saying exactly what we're talking about. He's saying that waking up, opening up the eyes, being able to feel grateful, and to even remind ourselves or to have a mantra saying, I am grateful for this new day, and knowing that, because then he writes, but there never seems to be enough time to do the things you want to do once you find them.
And why do you think that is, Bruce?
I think that is because the old cliche phrase that we like to say that time is so much faster when you're having fun, that is part of that. Because when we are enjoying what we are doing, time seems to fly by.
That is true, but
and
I also...
Or it can also stop. I'm sorry, it can also stop.
Well, that's true, and I think that feeling of not having enough time is that disconnect from all that is.
Because
when you're in that flow, the time doesn't exist, and even if it flies by, everything that you've experienced during that time has been such a blessing that the things you wanted to do, it don't really, you know, come at you, or you don't worry about them because everything you've done has just been fun,
amazing, and blissful.
Yeah,
and even though the time flies, it feels like it flew by because you suddenly look and you're like, oh my gosh, we just spent this much time doing this, because it was all like a singular moment where time literally stopped.
Yeah.
In the way that where you were and where I believe that I am sometimes is in a place where time has stopped. And yes, time is moving somewhere else around me. but I'm not in a place where that is happening.
Right.
I am certain of that. Yes, I feel that. And that's where I feel like he says that, because he says, I've looked around enough to know that you are the one I want to go through time with. And that beautiful phrase to me kind of sums up that acknowledgement of, yes, you know, there is this lament, but that is all it is.
Yeah.
That is all it is, because, you know, we all would, you know, we all can have, we all have these beautiful memories, these beautiful pictures of things that we've done. And that just, it's such an added flavor to what our experiences are.
Yeah, yeah. You know? And this is a beautiful example of one, because we have so much fun doing this and sharing wisdom with each and every one of you.
Yeah.
And time flies.
Time flies.
Every time we do this. It's like, wow, okay, it's already, you know,
it's
that
time.
It's fascinating how when you are doing things you love, you forget about time.
You do.
And for me, that is time in a bottle.
It is.
Because it doesn't exist, it's in a bottle.
It is, it is. It's amazing,
yeah.
Isn't it? And it is, it's amazing. This is Jim Croce, Time in a Bottle. He had a family member who, her name is Arlen Croce, and she is has been a writer in the arts. And I've actually had the fortune of meeting her as one of the writers or critics, if you will, when I was dancing with Miami City Ballet back in the day. Just really, honestly, very amazing ways with words. Wow.
That's fascinating.
These words are just such, yeah. I agree with the
words
idea
are wands.
Yes, really
words are wands.
Thank you, Vanya.
Thank you, Vanya, so much for this beautiful song, Time in a Bottle.
Thank you.
Yes, and time to let the genie out of the bottle, I guess, and say goodbye to you all. But we will see you all next week.
Yes.
We so enjoy this, and remember, please check us out on YouTube and subscribe, like, watch, comment. You can also leave a request in a comment on our YouTube channel.
Yes, you can.
Yes. So remember, send those requests to
Lyrical Wisdom on YouTube, or you can also send it to lyricalwisdomshow@gmail.com. That's lyricalwisdomshow@gmail.com. And we can also send them to 99.1 FM WQEE directly at 99classicrock@gmail.com. That's 99classicrock@gmail.com.
Thank you all so much for being here now with us this morning. We've had a great time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
If I had a box just for wishes and dreams that had never come true, the box would be empty except for the memory of how they were answered by you. But there never seems to be enough time to do the things.
This is DJ Commando of a 45's Affair radio show, where I play all vinyl 45s. You're listening to WQEE 99.1 FM, Newnan, Georgia.